Kate. I am really excited to ignite today on digital badges. Digital badges acknowledge and honor the informal learning that we participate in because we're innovators and we take on challenges, we share our successes openly, but sometimes it's nice to get a little recognition. So I married an Eagle Scout, and yes, he is always prepared. My husband spent years learning random skills, and he earned badges. He wore them with pride. So let's go on a digital badge journey and think about how prepared you are. Can't host open house without computers. Blogs, wikis, and shared documents capture the learning process, but they don't print well. So do you use computers to show off process as much as product? Drill-free zone. Drills have been known to stifle the four C's. Do you create lessons that encourage students to communicate and collaborate? Does the culture of your learning space truly embrace creativity? Flexible desk arrangements. Whether it's pairs, trios, or quads, your space should scream collaboration. How easy is it to move the seats around your classroom? Is your classroom design one that promotes flexibility? Classroom coach. When I stopped teaching and started coaching, I felt the entire culture of my classroom change. Kids looked to me for guidance rather than answers, and then they looked to each other for support and partnership. My classroom is a computer lab. What I'm really asking you to think about is how often your lessons invite your students to use technology. If I walked into your room, would I see students using devices every day? Open notes assessments. I love seeing the confidence in a child when they're given a chance to demonstrate their learning in an authentic way. Do your assessments include more open-ended and evidence-based questions? Teacher as student, student as teacher. Everyone in a learning space should share knowledge. Have you let your students know that you are learning alongside them? Flipping the role of teacher to learner and vice versa is so powerful. Cloud-dependent creator. How many of us have a smartphone, a tablet, a laptop, maybe even a desktop? The cloud allows you to stay organized, no matter what the device. Cross-curricular blogger. How many bloggers do we have in here? Great. So blogging is private and public, and we want to help others as much as we want to reflect. So do you provide angles in your blog posts that speak to a wide audience? Citation superstar. Media is so easily accessed that we not only should, but we must cite our sources. Plus, let's be honest, EasyBib and Google Research have pretty much taken all the excuses off the table. Footprint. We each need to be in charge of our digital footprint, not a victim to it. Do you Google yourself regularly? And does that include Google Images? No, we can't control the photos we're tagged in. But can we? Digital newsletter campaign. I can't think of a better way to share the innovative learning in your classroom than to create a digital newsletter. How do you help parents understand what you're doing with technology in the classroom? Global problem solver. How can you design your projects with a more global twist? Are you ready to abandon the traditional research paper and embrace genius hour? Do you create space in which students learn about global events and then discuss how to be a part of the solution? Curiosity counts. Allowing students and teachers to see you honor your own curiosities gives them permission to do the same. This badge is all about modeling the process of inquiry. Are you comfortable saying, good question, let's look it up? Curating with a purpose. I can't say enough how important it is to consciously organize your digital toolbox as you fill it. No one wants to make the time to organize after the fact. Presenter at a staff meeting. By stepping up and sharing with your peers, you help others notice the support structure around them. So do you model risk-taking for your peers by taking risks yourself? How do you use staff meetings to engage and grow other teachers? 1,000 tweets, 250 followers. This badge signifies that you are officially active in your professional learning network. You probably participate in Twitter chats, and you actively share with your digital community. What does your PLN look like? And finally, got my mind blown at ISTE Atlanta. Maybe this was your first ISTE, like me. Maybe you're a veteran, Either way, you're full of new ideas and new connections. You came, you fought, you conquered. Congrats.